Welcome back. Yes. Standing with these two lovely ladies in yellow. Cute. I feel privileged.
Yeah, you're welcome.
For many of us, mealtimes are hurried and not a lot of thought goes into the process, but with a little preparation, it can go a very long way when it comes to your health.
All right, so we love this lady, Susan Albers Bowling. She's mm-hmm. a psychologist with the Cleveland Clinic, right. And she is here to give us a quiz on what it means to eat mindfully.
Good morning. What do you mean by that?
Mindful eating, it's slowing down, enjoying your food, really savoring it.
Okay. You eat fast.
Something I don't do.
It's hard. I do too, because we're always on the clock, right. I feel like.
Right. Yes.
Shove it down.
So we have a quiz.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so here's our first question. Okay. Which fork will help you to slow down when you eat? So I'll give these to you. Mm-hmm. You can hold these.
Doesn't matter if it's plastic
now,
or...
Here's your hint.
Okay.
Feel it in your hand.
A heavier one.
Heavier. Yes, that is correct. One point. Studies show that utensils that are heavier, actually, we feel them, so we slow down.
Are you kidding
when
me?
When we slow down, we enjoy
plastic feels like
food.
Nothing. You just go.
You just, just go to town, huh?
Which is what you do with your fruit.
That's very
so you should start. No, fruit's good.
Heaviest fork. Yes. Okay.
There you go.
Now, imagine that in the morning, you're packing up your lunch. What container do you use? Do you use a plastic bag, a container, or a bento box?
Which should we use?
Yes, which one should you use?
I would say this.
Correct.
Yes.
Oh.
Bingo.
Yes,
great. Okay, so bento boxes, these are really popular in Japan.
I need those.
And but what I love about them is that they're sectioned out, and this helps you to be more mindful of your portions. And consistent. When you eat the same amount every day, it helps to train your appetite to want the same amount of food.
I have a problem with portion control.
Yeah, we all
try
do.
Try these, yes.
Right, and the food comes on the shelf, it's like, rah, we haven't eaten in a week.
We do that. So which plate is going to help you to stop eating and eat less? Yes.
The red one.
That is absolutely
right. Now, why
red.
Is that?
That's because when we see the color red,
it may
our
stop?
Brain...
Is that what it is?
That's right.
It
just, we stop.
Okay.
It's encoded into our brains. We
I
don't really
that.
Even have to think
well,
about
you know
it.
What? Can I take this home?
Yeah.
I think we all need a red plate.
We
go
all need
out
a red
and
plate.
Get a red plate
yes.
today. But you can also use napkins and bowls.
Yeah, just something red.
Yeah.
Just help to help you to slow down.
Okay.
Now.
Interesting.
Okay, so the next one is audio. What do you, which music helps you to eat less, fast music or slow music?
I would
slow.
Slow?
Classical.
Classical music. That's right, yes.
Did you feed her the answers before
I
we
did.
Started?
She's just good. She's good.
No, she
so
did not.
So slow, relaxing music actually helps you to slow down while you eat, and studies show that you enjoy the food more when the music is slow. In contrast to fast food restaurants that play really fast music, and the intention is to hurry you up and get you out the door. Exactly.
We can hear music in our ear. If you're wondering why we just did that, she can't hear it.
Okay.
I feel like you guys are weird.
Okay. So now, pistachios.
Yes.
If you are a stress eater, these are one of my favorite foods. They're very nutrient dense. They help you to feel fuller. But do you buy them out of the shells or in the shells?
In the shells.
In the shells, right. It's called the pistachio effect. Anything that helps you to slow down when they're deshelled,
then
you just
you slow
scoop
down.
And
you're
eat.
Right.
Yes.
And you
same
just eat
peanuts,
them mindlessly.
Right?
Yes,
same
it
thing.
Takes too long.
Yeah.
And,
so buy them
so
in the shells.
So workout to get into that shell.
It just takes some time.
Yes.
It takes some time.
Yeah,
and at the end, there's a little pile of shells, so you know visually
how many you've eaten.
So it's a visual cue
this
as well.
This is fun.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you guys are good.
Yes, we are.
All right, so breakfast time.
Yes.
Do you put your cereal in the bowl first or milk?
Milk.
I put cereal in there first.
Well, I do, but you should put milk?
You should put the cereal in first because... We have a lot of routines when it comes to eating.
Okay.
And the order in which you eat is actually very important.
Okay.
So putting the cereal in first, you have a visual instead of hiding it under the milk. You don't really see how much you put in.
Oh.
Also, it gets less soggy if you just put it in.
Okay, because I put mine in and then I tend to put a lot of cereal in the bowl.
Mm-hmm.
Then I got to fill it with milk to cover the top.
Cover the cereal.
Which doesn't make sense at all because that's not right. Moving on.
So my favorite one is ice cream. Which way... helps you to eat it more mindfully, in the bowl or on a cone?
I'm gonna say cone.
In a bowl.
We're gonna go with cone. A study out of New Zealand found that when you eat it on the cone, it releases the fat in a different way because your tongue warms up the ice cream versus a spoon, which insulates from your tongue.
Oh.
So it warms it up and it actually gives it more flavor, releases it. So try
it. My
reasoning
was because you gotta eat the cone, which is more calories. That's where my head was, my mind.
Actually, as you lick, it slows you down, too. It's more fun that way, as well.
Okay, yeah. Good to
All right, here's our last one. Ready? Okay, chocolate. we eat chocolate when we're stressed, right?
Is that what it is?
We do, often.
So I'm always stressed. I got issues.
You got a lot of chocolate? You like, okay.
And it's soothing, right?
Right? Yeah.
So now, does a good feeling last 3 minutes, 10 minutes, or 1 hour?
When you eat a piece of chocolate?
When you eat a piece of chocolate. How long does it make you feel good?
3 minutes. Because I want another
I'm going 3 minutes, too.
You're absolutely right. Yeah. That feel-good feeling
it's
is really fleeting. Yeah. It's so quick.
Yeah.
So it's really important that we find other ways to help to soothe and calm ourselves besides eating chocolate.
Right. Yeah.
Should we still have a piece of dark chocolate a day?
It is fine to eat chocolate. Dark chocolate, absolutely. I love chocolate. Just eat it mindfully, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. And then your new book, this is your newest one out of the 100 that you have.
This is Hanger Management.
Hangry, remember?
And what you noticed are all these tips are really simple and easy.
Yeah.
And they're just a little bit of, it's almost like dead on mind tricks, right?
Yes.
Yes.
You're not kidding.
To think about it a little bit differently. And
so it's just like Scott Sable, though, when he's hanging.
Yeah. The front cover of her book? Absolutely.
We all get hangry.
That's once a day, at least.
Yeah. Thank you so much for coming.
You did very well. You get an A+ on your quiz.
Who did better? You can tell us.
We're twins today. You have to say me.
I plead the fifth. I think you both agree.
Okay, you won't be back.
She's only kidding.
She's only kidding. She didn't even watch us, and she wore the same color.
She did.
Anyway.